Valentino giving me shoes.
Tupac Mobb Deep shit happened. You know what I mean? He was really, he ain't say nothing about Nas, but he shitted on Mobb Deep. So you shit it on Queensbridge, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And as a kid, KRS-One did that to Queensbridge, and we don't play that no more.
We was at the MTV Music Awards, you know what I mean? Nas had to give an award. Because
it's Smoke Chips, not Drake Chips.
So he went to the back. So fucking, I was like, yo, I'm going to be at the bar waiting for you, you know what I mean? I'm going to wait for you to get that award. I'm going to the bar. When I went to the bar, I seen this girl. You know, I'm like, I try to bag this girl. I'm like, where you going? She's like, I'm looking for my friends. I'm like, who's your friends? She said, Death Row. I said, damn. So I'm like, yo, you with me. Fuck Death Row and all this shit. She's like, what? Yo, they are deep. They going to jump you and all that. And I was like, yo, what? I will take a chain. When I see them, I'm going to take a chain. Yeah. She was like, you know, you crazy. You better not try to.
This is Death Row.
This is Tupac is there in the house. Tupac is just handed out an award.
He passed away.
Oh, I seen him at the MTV Awards. Nigga, nigga, we had to go to the awards and shit. Nigga sent me home 2 days early to go get some reinforcements. So I got about 150 niggas from Jersey to come up there to New York to the MTV Awards to hold Pac down. And that's the last time I seen him.
Okay, and how was the atmosphere around these MTV Awards?
It was 150 Jersey niggas, young Jersey niggas, all fatal boys. You let me know how you think the atmosphere was. You saw the clip. It's a clip. It's a 1996 Tupac interview.
Well, he's talking about Death Row East.
Yeah, about five niggas had guns, and you know that was all on the strength of me. That's probably, you know, if I'd have seen Tupac any time after that, I probably definitely would be crowned for real.
Okay.
But yeah, the atmosphere was pretty wild, man. If it wasn't for Pac, you know. He was responsible of a lot of entertainers making it home that night. A lot of New York entertainers making it home that night. Let's just say that.
The Bad Boy camp was there as well, right?
Definitely not. There wasn't nobody. No camp was nowhere near where we was at in New York. Okay. Nobody at all. Only person that came there was Nas and his three friends.
Can you tell me something about it? Because Tupac dissed Nas a few times in his track. And Nas is saying that they just made peace on that award show.
Well, at the award show, Pop did. They did, you know, they did make a little, you know, I wouldn't call it peace, but they spoke. And what they were talking about, that was between them two because, you know, Pac had to definitely tell some of my boys to chill out because they was in Nas's ear and in Nas's face yelling at him at the top of their fucking lungs. And Pac was really mad because he couldn't get a word in. So he basically had to, you know, pull his rank on some of my soldiers just to get them niggas to stop fucking with Nas so he can have his word with him and shit. And when they did speak, you know, they spoke between them two.
Giving me suits, gang.
21 gun salute, Stealing a Pac chain? To praise Jungle for not stealing a chain? Like,
do you think, Jung, right on cue. Yo. Right on cue.
Yo, what up, guys?
He's in the building. Right?
Hey, bro, what's happening, man? Yo, I was just telling him last time I saw you sticking me up for like 40 Summer Jam passes.
Yeah, you was the greatest that day, too. You helped make history, Queensbridge history.
It was crazy.
Yo, I didn't know you was coming here. This is the first time I think you ever been at a interview with me in a room. As I'm talking about you.
No, we was just talking about MTV.
How did you know I was here?
I was scheduled to be here with you, but I got I'm a little late.
Somebody was smart to do that.
Yo, so this is the first brother interview. Have y'all ever done an interview together?
We probably did, but I don't know where that footage is.
Yo, so. Let's just pick up where we was. You was talking MTV Awards.
Oh man,
and Moose do you remember and Pop
how clear do you remember? I'm in the seats at the spot, and somebody came and said, "Yo, your brother number's getting it on in the lobby or whatever, or something like that." So I got up and I went out there, but it was already squashed at that point. So you was out there. You was out there with the Outlaws and Pac. Yeah, shout out to the Outlaws, Edie, Napoleon, Oh man!
Yeah, you you had to present an award or something, and you was like, "Yo, I'll be right back," because we all couldn't go with you. I was still a teenager. And I forgot how old I was, but I was definitely wasn't 20 yet. And we, I went to get a drink, and I saw this girl that looked lost. So I'm like, "Where are you going?" You know what I mean? She's like, "I'm looking for my friends." I said, "Who? Death Row." I was like, "What?" When I see one of them, I'm gonna take a chain. You know what I mean? She was laughing. I was trying to make her laugh to come get a drink with me, but I was on some Queensbridge Mobb Deep. You know what I mean? It's like, yeah, Mobb Deep in a house. I'm going to take a chain. And she was laughing. And then they came
shout
around
out to Havoc.
Mm-hmm. They started rest coming
in peace
for real.
To P.
And she said, here they come, and looking at me with
why
the
did
face.
You say Mobb Deep? You was just bobbing?
Nah, because on the song,
oh, they had they was dissing
they
each other.
Hit
okay.
Them up already.
Yeah, they hit it's them up a QB thing.
They dissed
okay.
Mobb Deep on Hit
yeah,
Them Up.
For sure, for sure.
So, she said, here they come now. And she gave me that look like, I know you're not going to do all that stuff you were saying. And when they was coming, I yelled it out. Yo, Mobb Deep in the house, I will take a Death Row chain. And they was all looking, what? They all.
I don't think Mobb Deep know this story.
They might not. Nah.
Yeah.
And then they got ready, but then they all left. They went to go get Tupac. You know, they wasn't with Tupac. He was backstage doing the awards. Too, and they came right back with Pac, and he's looking like, who said that? And I was like, oh God. And I was with his guy Moose, and Moose was like, man, yo, I got you. I see everybody, and they don't even know I'm with you. And he's like this karate expert from Queensbridge. Yeah. This is before security guards. Yeah. So when he said that, I was like, all right, cool. Mobb Deep, and I said it again, Mobb Deep, what's up, Pac? Like, what's up? I'll take your chain right now. Well, you know what I mean? And then they surrounded me again. They surrounded me. Oh, what's up with you? All of this. And Death Row, we here to die. You don't know Death Row. They had razors in their hands, everything.
They said we here to die. They said we here to die.
Gaddafi, the one with the dread, oh, the braids
yeah.
going back, the light skin dude.
Oh, yeah, rest in peace, Gaddafi. Yeah.
He said that. He said, I'm Death Row. I'm here to die, boy. I said,
that's
whoa.
Hard.
Mm-hmm. That was when it got scary a little bit. That was the first time my heart was.
He was like, oh, this
I
ain't.
I said, this is this serious. Is real. Yeah. So, you know, I got ready. I just got ready. Like, if they start jumping, I'm going to go crazy. Like, I'm not going to just let nobody do
now,
that.
Now, was this just Jersey dudes, outlaw dudes? Or was this also, because in the song Death Row East, you specifically, Nas, talk about cats from Queens, from the city,
well,
rocking these Death Row East t-shirts.
The Death Row East thing was given to Eric B. And another solid individual out of Queens, Big D, and somebody else, you know who you are, and just it was. I was surprised to see Eric was there in the park. This is out. This is not that incident. This is a separate incident.
Yeah, Brian, when that didn't happen, I was just like the Outlaws and a got couple it. Of okay. Death Row
yeah,
guys.
Yeah,
yeah. It wasn't like 100 deep yet.
Got it.
You
got
know?
It.
Yeah. Yeah. You see how this is a story. This is a crate even to this day. This is one song. I think we're gonna shoot a small documentary on this thing because it's like it's so much into this song. It's like there needs to be like a little short film.
But also to the timeline, because even in this song, Death Row East, from you talking about, and like I was saying, like I never thought about it through the lens of like, there's this beef going on, and then this record label, who's the biggest in the game, says, you know what, to exacerbate and really make this issue even worse, we're going to pay individuals in New York, and we're going to set up a label in New York.
That's pretty genius.
So to fragment
genius.
This, yeah. Even, like on some real art of war shit, to
war.
Fragment the base of like, because, I mean, you was there, Jungle, you was there at the time. Mm-hmm. I was in radio at the time. It was really it started as a Death Row Bad Boy thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Then the Mobb Deep disses and all that other came along, and then it broadened out to this really, Death Row versus the East Coast.
Yeah.
Then it started to form into this East Coast, West Coast thing, but that's not how it really started.
No, mm-mm. No. Mm-mm. And I don't think that's how they wanted it to end.
Well, at the award show, Pop did, they did, you know, they did make a little, you know, I wouldn't call it peace, but they spoke, and what they were talking about, that was between them two, because, you know, Pac had to definitely tell some of my boys to chill out because they was in Nas's ear and in Nas's face, yelling at the top of their fucking lungs, And Pac was really mad because he couldn't get a word in. So he basically had to, you know, pull his rank on some of my soldiers just to get them niggas to stop fucking with Nas so he can have his word with him and shit. Hey. Valentino.